Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello everyone, welcome to second PUC Statistics online classes. In the previous class, we had discussed about some important problems of test for variance. In this class, we are going to discuss the remaining important problems of test for variance. In that, problem number 7, that is, weights in kg of 10 students are given below, that is 38, 40, 45, 53, 47, 43, 55, 48, 52 and 49. Can we say that variance of the distribution of weights is equal to 20 kg square? See, here given observation is, see, this is one set of observation. So, set of observation is denoted by x, and that set of observation is denoted by x. So, here x is, here x is, that is weights in kg of 10 students. And these are the x observations. And here given observations are, can we say that variance of distribution of weights is equal to 20 kg square? So, 20 kg square, in the sense, here sigma square is given. See, this is variance in the sense what? That is population variance. So, variance is denoted by sigma square, and given observation is 20. And here alpha is 5%. So, alpha, level of significance is 0.05. It means that is 5%. And next, see the question, that is the variance of the distribution of weights is equal to 20 kg square. So, equal to, in the sense what? That is like this. See, this is equal to type. So, if it is equal to type, then we can say that is null hypothesis. And null hypothesis is denoted by H naught. This is step 1. So, here step 1 is, the distribution of weights is equal to 20 kg square. Distribution of weights is equal to 20 kg square. So, we can say sigma square is equal to 20. And H1, that is step 2 is H1. H1 is, that is possible rejection of null hypothesis. See, this is equal to type, in the sense we can say that is not equal to. H1 is not equal. So, that is sigma square is not equal to 20. When it is not equal to 20, sigma square is not equal to 20, the sentence is like this. The distribution of weights is not equal to 20 kg square. Then we can say sigma square is not equal to 20. So, that is H1 is, the distribution of weights is not equal to 20 kg. Here x observations are like this, that is, here x is weights in kg of 10 students, and observations are, the first observation 38, 40, 45, 53, 47, 43, 55, 48, then 52 and 49. Okay, let me cross check, that is first observation 38, 40, 45, 53, 47, 43, 55, 48, 52 and 49. Okay, these are the x observations. And next move to step 3, that is test statistics. So test statistic is that is chi square is equal to summation xi minus x bar, or we can say x minus x bar whole square divided by sigma square, which follows chi square with n minus 1 degrees of freedom. And see, based on formula, next we need to find x bar, and next we need to find x minus x bar. So next column is x minus x bar, and based on formula we need x minus x bar whole square, therefore we need to find x minus x bar. First I will find out x bar. So x bar formula is summation x divided by n. So see here, x observations are there. Next we need to find summation x. So first observation is 38 plus 40 plus 45 plus 53 plus 47 plus 43 plus 55 plus 48 plus 52 plus 49. That sum total is 470. See, here the first observation is 38, 40, 45, 53, 47, 43, 55, 48, 52 and 49. So sum of that total is sum of that answer observation is 470 divided by what is n here. That n is given in the question, so that is 10 student, or else here the given observations are 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So n is 10. In the place n I will substitute 10. So 470 divided by 10 is, that is 47. So here we got x bar observation. So in the place x bar I will write here. Here x bar is 47. And see here, first x observation is 38. 38 minus 47, that is minus 9. Next 40 minus 47, that is minus 7. Next 45 minus 47, that is minus 2. Then 53 minus 47, 6. Then 47 minus 47, 0. Then 43 minus 47, that is minus 4. Then 55 minus 47, that is 8. Then 48 minus 7, minus 47, that is 1. Then 52 minus 47, that is 5. The last observation, that is 49 minus 47, that is 2. These are x minus x bar observation. And here next we need to find x minus x bar whole square. So here x minus x bar observations are like this. So now we are going to take square of this observation. So 9 square, that is 9 square is 81. Then 7 square is 49, 2 square is 4, 6 square is 36, 0 square is 0, minus 4 square is 16, 8 square is 64, then 1 square is 1, 5 square is 25 and 2 square is 4. Next we need to find sum of these observations, that is 81 plus 49 plus 4 plus 36 plus 0 plus 16 plus 64 plus 1 plus 25 plus 4, that is 280. So sum of x minus x bar whole square is 280. 280 divided by sigma square value is, we got sigma square value that is given in the question. So sigma square value is 20. So 280 divided by 20, that is 14. So here x square, that is chi square value is calculated, chi square value is 14. And next step 4, that is here alpha is 5% and degrees of freedom, that is n minus 1, here n is 10, 10 minus 1 is 9 and this is not equal to type, so here test is 2-tailed. So we need to find the critical values are like this. Critical values are k1 and k2. So that value I will find using statistical table, and see here degrees of freedom is 90 and this is 2-tailed test, and here alpha is 5%. I'm sorry, here alpha is 1%, okay, this is alpha is 1%, that is 0.01. if alpha is 0.01, we can say this is 1%. If it is 1%, then k1 value is 6.84 and k2 value is 38.6. okay, I'm sorry, this is 5% only. Yeah, that is given in the question, isn't it? Yeah, here alpha is 0.05. So if it is 0.05, here 5%, and here degrees of freedom, see 10 minus 1 in the sense what, that is 9, and alpha is 5% and this is 2-tailed test, therefore k1 value is 2.70 and k2 value is 19. These are the critical values. Here critical values are k1 is 2.70 and k2 is 19, and this is 2-tailed test in the sense, yeah, we know that chi-square value, range of chi-square is 0 to infinity, and this is 2-tailed test, so here rejection region located at both the tail of probability curve like this. This is k1, that is 2.70, and this is k2, that is 19, and this is rejection region, and this is rejection region, and this is acceptance region. And see here calculated value is 14, so 14 is here, 14 is comes here, so this is calculated value, that is 14. And see here calculated value lies in acceptance region, therefore we can say H not accepted. Calculated value lies in acceptance region, therefore H not accepted. Or one more condition is K1 less than or equal to calculated value of chi square less than or equal to K2. See here K1 value is 2.70 and calculated value is 14, and k2 value is 19. See the here 14 is greater than 2.70, so the sign is like this, and here 19 is greater than 14, so the sign is like this. See here condition is satisfied, therefore H not accepted. If H not accepted, the conclusion is the distribution of weights, so the distribution of weights of 10 students are equal. Conclusion is the distribution of weights are equal to 20 kg square, that we can say sigma square is equal to 20. Okay, next move to problem number 8, that is the variance of the heights of 20 SLC students is 4 cm². Test at 1% level of significance that variance of heights of SLC student is more than 3 cm². See here given observations are, that is C see the variance of the heights of 20 students. So 20 SLC students in the sense that here n is given, n, 20 SLC students in the sense what? That is sample size. Here sample size is denoted by small letter n and given observation is 20. And students is 4 centimeter square. Here 4 centimeter square is that is variance. So here 20 is sample. So here this variance is sample variance. So sample variance is denoted by S square. The given observation is 4. And see, test at 1% level of significance. In the sense here alpha is given, that is 1%. And the heights of SLC students is more than 3 centimeter square. So here 3 is sigma square. That is population variance, that is 3 centimeter square. And see, here the question is like this. The variance of heights of SLC students is more than 3 centimeter square. See, more than sign is like this. The sign is greater than type. So here given problem is based on alternative hypothesis. And so here H naught and H1s are. First I will write H1 because this problem is based on alternative hypothesis. So here H1 is the variance of heights of SLC students is more than 3 centimeter square. That is sigma square greater than 3 centimeter square. See, here the sign is greater than, so this is upper tail test. Or we can say right tail test. Here H1 is sigma square greater than 3, then what is H0? H0 is always equal to type, that we can write sigma square is equal to 3. When it is sigma square is equal to 3, if it is variance of heights of SLC students is 3 centimeter, then we can say sigma square is equal to 3. So here H naught is variance of heights of SLC students is 3 centimeter square. Then we can say sigma square is equal to 3. Here step 3 is test statistic. That is chi square is equal to n s square divided by sigma square, which follows chi square with n minus 1 degrees of freedom. And see here given observation. What is n? N is 20 into s square, that is 4, divided by sigma square, that is 3. So this is equal to 20 into 4, that is 100. Sorry, 20 into 4, that is 80. 80 divided by 3, that is 26.66. Yeah, here chi square value is, calculated value is 26.66. This is calculated value. And yeah, this is step 3. Then step 4 is, here alpha is 1% and degrees of freedom. So how to calculate degrees of freedom? That is n minus 1. Here n is 20, n minus 1, that is 19. So here n degrees of freedom is 19, and this is upper tail test, or we can say this here test is one tail test. Therefore, critical value is K2. So K2 value is, see here degrees of freedom is 19 and this is one tail test, and here alpha is 1%. So K2 value is 36.2. So K2 is 36.2. And we know that here rejection region, if it is one tail or if it is upper tail, we can say upper tail or right tail, we can say here rejection region located at right tail of the probability curve, and here chi square range is 0 to infinity. This is rejection region, and we can say this is K2 area. So K2 value is 36.2. See, this is rejection region and this is acceptance region, and here calculated value is 26.66, that comes here. So this is calculated value, that is 26.66, and see here calculated value lies in, acceptance region. Therefore, H naught accepted. Or one more condition for upper tail test or right tail test, that is chi square value, calculated value less than or equal to K2. See here, K2 value is 36.2, and chi square value is 26.66. And see here, 36.22 is greater than 26.66, then we can say H naught accepted. If H naught accepted, the conclusion is variance of heights of SSLC students is 3 cm. Therefore, the conclusion is variance of heights of SSLC students is 3 cm square, that is sigma square is equal to 3 cm square. Okay, this is the conclusion. Yes, thank you for watching this video.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.